Hello and welcome. This video explains the need for comparable city data. It tells you the story of the World Council on City Data and ISO 37120, the first international standard on city indicators. Many cities want to create a high quality of life for their citizens and share the goals of becoming prosperous and environmentally friendly, smart, resilient and sustainable. However, a critical question is, how can these goals be accomplished? And how can cities become self-sustaining? An important step involves leveraging city data and linking this to map graphical information systems like GIS to create relevant stakeholder information and develop efficient planning processes for the city itself. There is a general understanding about the growing importance of cities and metropolitan regions in the global context. Regions, cities and neighborhoods within cities need to utilize benchmarking tools to understand where specific improvements are needed. Like a student concerned about mediocre grades in school, a city should be concerned with its own performance as well, where it appears in international rankings and so on. However, until recently it was almost impossible to find high quality data and third-party verified and open data at city level. The process of data collection can be approached in several ways, both by interacting directly with local citizens, of course, by asking them, but also by leveraging established data and collecting new data about specific issues. To make these benchmarks useful for improving the policies of the city, in this case for the city of Rotterdam in the Netherlands, a group of researchers compared available rankings and benchmarks. Although existing benchmarks were useful for specific purposes, there were several essential pieces missing from the data, including the following. Often there was no feedback on city scores, which left the cities with question marks where to improve their policies. Standardized third-party verified data were not there. Indicator evolution, as there was no feedback to the cities, was not happening because cities could not give feedback to the ranking organizations. Weighing indicators became a black box, as many different themes were combined in one indicator. Furthermore, there were issues like resilience and adaptation capacity, governance, use of local potentials such as renewables, but also indirect impact of consumption elsewhere, such as footprint analysis. Let us now look at existing indicators and what they were used for. In 2007, the University of Toronto started building the Global Cities Indicators Facility Framework as an assignment by the World Bank. It turned out that 7 cities were using 1,100 indicators together. Yet only 6 of them were the same. So it was clear that a new framework had to be built. Together with the cities, this framework was built, and in 4 years' time, 255 cities in 82 countries were involved in doing so. And to make sure all of these data were delivered with a good quality, the existing framework was taken to ISO to become a voluntary standard. 2 years later, in May 2014, the first international standard on city data, ISO 37120, was published. With the publication of this standard, also the World Council on City Data was founded, a platform for cities worldwide. Good comparable city data can be used by policymakers, mayors or researchers to actually manage, to benchmark, to leverage funding, to plan and evaluate the policies in their own cities. The new international platform for city data is supported by many organizations, ranging from UN bodies, global companies, and dozens of cities worldwide, like Amsterdam and the ISO pilot city Rotterdam. 20 so-called foundation cities, which are actually worldwide, are voluntarily certified. Already more than 40 cities have signed up, with an additional 100 cities waiting to join as well. The standard is built around a framework of 100 indicators across 17 themes, which are related to social, economic and environmental issues ranging from education, health to water sanitation. The ISO standard makes sure data are of high quality, but they are also third-party verified, and they are all open data. In the development of city indicators, there are now two new areas we are looking at. One is resilient cities, and the other one is smart cities, because many cities deal with questions related to these themes. The data are used for studies, such as this overview of aging cities worldwide, which helps cities, but also UN bodies to help to develop health policies for these cities. Please visit the open data platform at www.dataforcities.org. Compare these data as a source for inspiration for improvements in your own environment.